in seasons of distress and grief. My soul has often found relief and oft escaped the tender snare by thy return. Sweet all. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for this medium of prayer. We thank you, Lord, that we can come to you at this time. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity given to us, where we can meet in this fashion. Lord, we have been at home for many weeks, many days. We have missed our church activities, mighty God. But we thank you once more that the channel is open. While not on a wholesale basis, but mighty God, we have an opportunity to come together in corporate worship. We have opportunity to unite together to do exploits in your name. Amen. We have opportunity, mighty God, to reach out to our communities. We have opportunity, oh God, to do what you call us to do. And God, we give you thanks. We pray, oh God, that we will use these opportunities wisely and that this new way of doing things, mighty God, will put us in a new path and a new relationship with you. Thank you, God. The Bible says, the word says in everything we have to give thanks. Sometimes we complain, mighty God, but you are able to take the complaints and open avenues whereby, God, we can serve you in other ways. Mighty God, we pray for our church, Grace Baptist Church at this time. Lord, we may be a bit disappointed because we were looking for more people to turn out on this morning of rejoicing and thanksgiving. But Lord, you are here.
Yes.
We will give thanks and we will lift up our voices.
Yes.
And we will praise and honor.
Yes.
And we will seek to give you sincere worship and sincere praise.
Yes.
Lord, we pray for the programs of the church. We pray, God, that you will open up avenues for us to do them in different ways. We pray, God, that as members, we will not be discouraged, but oh God, we will be encouraged to continue to move on and to continue to trust you and to continue to ask for your leading and your guidance, because where you lead, we will follow. God, we pray for those who are affected by this coronavirus, this COVID-19. Mighty God, we don't even begin to study this disease yet. What scientists have not even though they feel. Because every day we hear of different effects that it is having on the body. Lord, we hear of effects it's now having on children. We hear about effects that it has on young people of body causing strokes and other failure and systems in the body. We pray, oh God, that you know this disease, because nothing escapes you. We pray, God, that you will protect us and that you will help us, oh God, to be wise in all that we do. Mighty God, we pray for Jamaica. Our resources are stretched to the limit. Mighty God, we pray that your mighty hand will be upon this land and that you will stay this disease, oh God, and help us to move on in life. God, it is a world crisis, and you know what is happening elsewhere. You know that the world is a global village, and Lord, what happens in one part affects what happens in another part. So God, we pray, you are the creator, you are the sustainer of this vast universe. We pray, mighty God, that you will intervene at this time. We ask you now, oh God, that those among us who are sick, that you will touch us even today.
Yes.
Mighty God, we come out, some of us cannot so well, but God, we pray that vascular surgery. God, we pray for our young people at this time. Many of us, many of them, oh God, are uncertain, even about their examination. Their CXC and their paper and whatever pet they are to do. Mighty God, there's a new way, a new thing, a new way in your life. Mighty God, we pray that you will make those people who have the decision-making process to do, mighty God. You will be with them so that they will make the best decisions in the interest of the young people. We pray, oh God, that you will take over the rest of this service. And we pray, mighty God, that none of us who is here today, no one will left the way we came. Will none of us believe how we came this morning, oh God. But you will touch us afresh and revive us again. We pray for our pastor, we bring you word. We thank you for his leading in this time of crisis. Yes. Lord, we are certain, mighty God, that he's giving his best. And he's leading from the front. We pray, mighty God, that you will strengthen him and that none of his disease will touch him. Yes. Oh God, we listen now. We are listening for what you are going to say to us. And as we go, may we be encouraged to come. May we be your people in the community that you want us to be.
Yes, Lord.
Bless us afresh again, we pray, mighty God. Challenge us and help us to continue to follow you, for we pray in Jesus' name.
And Sister Charmaine Holmes will come and lead us in the reading of that. And right after Sister Charmaine, we'll have the Old Testament reading from Revelation 19, verse 11 to 16.
Moses and the children of Israel this song unto the Lord, and spake, saying, I will sing unto the Lord, for he hath triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider hath he thrown into the sea. The Lord is my strength and song, and he is become my salvation. He is my God, and I will prepare him an habitation, my father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. Pharaoh's chariots and his host have cast into this the sea. His chosen captains also are drowned in the Red Sea. The depth have covered them. They sank into the bottom as a stone. Thy right hand, O God, is become glorious in power. Thy right hand, O Lord, hath dashed in pieces the enemy. And in the greatness of thine excellency, thou hast overthrown them that rose up against thee. Thou sentest forth thy wrath, which consumed them as stubble. And with the blast of thy nostrils, the waters were gathered together. The flood stood upright as an heap, and the depths were concealed in the heart of the sea. The enemy said, I will pursue, I will overtake, I will divide the spoil. My lust shall be satisfied upon them. I will draw my sword, my hand shall destroy them. Thou didst blow with thy wind, the sea covered them, they sank as lead in the mighty waters. Who is like unto thee, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like thee, glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, in wonders? Thou stretchest out thy right hand, the earth swallowed them. Verse 13. Thou in thy mercy hast led forth peace. thou hast redeemed. Thou hast guided them in thy strength on thy holy habitation. This is the word of the Lord.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Our New Testament reading comes to us from Revelation 19, and I'll be reading from 11 to 16. I'll be reading from the American Standard Bible. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse, and he who sat upon it is called Faithful and True, and in righteousness he judges and wages war. And his eyes are a flame of fire, and upon his head are many diadems, and he has a name written upon him, which no one knows except himself. And he is clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. And the armies which are in heaven, clothed in fine linen, white and clean, were following him on white horses. And from his mouth comes a sharp sword, so that with it he may smite the nations, and he will rule them with a rod of iron. And he treads the winepress of the fierce wrath of God the Almighty. 16. And on his robe and on his thigh he has a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. The word of the Lord.
Amen. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And there shall be no doubt when he comes that he is indeed the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We continue to prepare ourselves to hear this special message, the special word, that will encourage, that will convict, that will give us something special to share as we go through this week. And we ask that you continue to be in prayer for Reverend Brenard as he prepares himself to come to us. Sister Faith will help us with our pre-sermon meditation by coming and doing a musical ministry piece. Good morning, everyone.
Thank you.